Hello guys, I want to welcome you all to the first episode of the Rise and Lead Show. This show is all about you and your business. My commitment every day going forward is to bring you resources, tools, information that will inspire you, motivate you, and put you in a better position to make something positive now and beyond these trying times, okay? So today we'll be looking at how to take super control of your life and your business. Over the course of this video, I'll be sharing with you five things you will do now to save, preserve, and better position yourself and your business today and beyond the COVID-19 season, okay? So when you look around, you find out that there are so much negativity going on now. So many things are happening. People, like, it's all about the bad news, okay? It's all about the negative news. Now, as an individual, as a person, if you don't take control of your life, this whole mess will mess you up. Yes, it will definitely mess you up. And before you know it, even after, because I always say that what we are going through now, what the world is going through now, what we are going through now shall pass. It's not going to last forever. It's not going to stay till the end of the world. No. A time comes when you look back and find out that this only happened for a season. But the worst thing that would happen is when that time comes, to also look at yourself and find out that because you allow the negativity, the bad news, the bad energy in the atmosphere right now to get to you, you lost sanity, you lost yourself, okay? So today's topic, I'll be diving right in on the five things you should do to save, preserve, and better position yourself and your business now and beyond these challenging times. So the first thing you have to do is to take full responsibility. Take full responsibility. Every aspect of your life, of your business, now is the time to take full responsibility. Now is not the time to make excuses. Now is not the time to blame the government, to blame that man of God or woman of God, to blame that your rich uncle, to blame the school system, to whoever it is. No, this is not the time for that. Because I've come to realize that when we stop taking responsibility, when you stop taking responsibility of your life and your business, what you do is to give away power. So within you, you feel you are no longer in control. You feel there is nothing you could do about it, but it shouldn't be. Take full responsibility. Your business, you're not making as enough money as you should. Take full responsibility. Probably before now, you don't have any digital presence. So what does that tell you? It means you have to start making plans. You have to start taking immediate action to give your business the online presence that it requires. That is you taking full responsibility. Your marriage is not working out well. Your relationship is not working out well. Don't look at your partner. Don't look beyond yourself. Take responsibility. Ask yourself, what is it that I'm not doing well? What is it that I can do better? Whichever aspect of your life that is not working out well, you are in a financially tight position, take responsibility. It is not your boss, it is not your business. You can actually, with this moment right now, the time you have on your hands, you can look for a good online business to start, okay? Mr. Chukwuma Ifremo Okemwa, thank you so much, sir, for coming on board. And as you join us on this live show, I would want you to leave a reaction. I would also want you to leave a comment, okay? So take full responsibility of your life, of your situation. It is all your fault. See it from that perspective. Whatever challenge you are going through now, whether financially, whether in marriage, your relationship, it is all your fault. No blames, no excuses. It is all your fault. Stop giving your power away. And when you start taking responsibility, it leads us to the second thing you have to do, which is focus on what you can control. Focus on what you can control. Recently, there is so much noise about the 5G network. Recently, there is so much noise about conspiracy theory. Who is COVID-19 was it pre-planned? Is it not pre-planned? Are there top guys, maybe someone, some superpowers that are behind it? What are they trying to achieve by making the virus go viral? So much conspiracy, the 5G network, this, that. You know what has taken up the social media in recent times, in the past couple of days and weeks. And all these things, okay, people argue, this pastor, is he this man of God, this woman of God, are they doing enough to help people? Why would you have a private jet when your church members are so? There are so many things going on right now. But the truth is, it doesn't leave you any better. These are things you don't have any control on. You cannot control it. If 5G network will come out the next day, which I believe they're already working towards that, you can't stop it. It's as simple as that. The man of God, the woman of God that you are pointing fingers at, that he is not doing enough to help his church members, you cannot control what he or she do with his money. The government might have failed us, but what can you do? You cannot control what they do. The only thing you have control over is what you as an individual can do right in this moment and beyond this moment. So that is what your focus should be on. What can you control? Focus on what you can control. And that goes back to taking responsibility. It is only when you have made the decision to take full responsibility of every aspect of your life, only then can you focus on what you can control. If you don't take full responsibility for yourself, for your life, for your business, there is no way you can focus on what you can control. So my question to you now is, what can you control? Solace Onyema, Babatunde David, thank you for coming on board. Like I said, if you can, you can always leave a comment and a reaction, okay? Let's make this engaging. So what can you control? What can you control? This is the question I want you to ask yourself and start coming up with answers to, okay? What can you control? The next thing is, what can you do with what you have now? Everybody is at home, lockdown, quarantine, whatever name you call it or you give it. Unfortunately, yes, workers, those under paid employment, you can't go to work. If you run a day-to-day business, not the online business, a day-to-day business that requires you have a physical store that requires that every day you should be present at your shop, at your place of business. Unfortunately, there is not much you can do about it, because we have been advised to stay at home, and it's for our own good. So while you stay at home, what can you do with what you have? People are already losing their jobs. Businesses are going under because of the season we are into. But does that mean there is no hope? No. Does that mean you have to feed your mind with negative energy, with negativity? No. What does that mean? You have to ask yourself, look inwardly, ask yourself, what do I have now that I can start with? What skill set do I have? What resources do I have? No matter how limited you think the resources might be, what contact or connection can I leverage on? What do I have now that I can start with? That's the question you have to ask yourself. And when you ask yourself this question, you might realize that what you need to start right now, possibly, probably you need to an upgrade on it. So for example, let me say you have been underpaid employment. Now you don't go to work. And I know there are bosses that will tell their employees, you guys have seen the current situation of things. Sorry, the company would not be able to keep up with your salary. So what are you going to do? Don't you think now is the right time to see how you can start an online business? And I say online business because I know it is what I do, and I know it's one business that no matter where you are, no matter the economic times, no matter what, you can always run it. At least with most online business models, you can always run it from anywhere, anytime, and you can always start with the limited resources you have. So what is it that you have now? What expertise have you acquired over the years that you can start teaching others? What knowledge, what skill set can you start selling? And if you look around, you find out that yes, so many marketers, so many entrepreneurs are now trying to teach people how to sell their skill, their expertise, their knowledge, their talent online. And it is because of the times we are into. Probably 2 months ago, a couple of weeks ago, you might not have taken this seriously, but now is time for you to take it very seriously. What can you start now with what you have? What you have is always enough to get you started. It's just that most times we think that we need one more, this extra thing, we need an extra, maybe an extra 10,000 naira, an extra 100,000 naira. We need to get an extra information. We need to get an extra this, an extra that before getting started. But that is not the case. Whatever you have now, you can start with. Wherever you are now, you can begin from. So what is it that you have now? Mr. Steve Nogugu, Alexander Kaduna, I can see you guys. I want to welcome you on board, okay? So you're welcome to the Rise and Lead Show. What can you do now with what you have? The limited resources you have, the skill set you have, the connection you have. What? Think. Put your mind to action. Put your mind to work. What can you do with what you have now? Okay, now the third thing, or rather the fourth thing you have to ask yourself is, or you have to do to take control of your life and your business, is don't beat yourself up. Because the moment you do the first thing, which is taking full responsibility, the moment you do the second thing, which is focusing on what you can control, the moment you do the third thing, which is asking yourself, what can I do with what I have right now? You're going to find out that there are things that you ought to have done in the past that you neglected or you didn't do quite well. Probably in the past, you neglected learning skills like copywriting, like digital marketing, Facebook advertising, YouTube advertising, Google advertising, skills like graphic design, and so on and so forth. Maybe these are the things you neglected in the past. Okay, now is not the time to beat yourself up, because we all have our own deficiencies. So when you start taking full responsibility of your life, you're going to find out that there are so many things you might not have done well in the past. There are so many things that you might have neglected. What do you do? Do you react negatively to it? No. Do you beat yourself up? No. Do you start throwing self-pity parties? No. You have to forgive yourself. You have to give yourself the permission to start with what you have and from where you are. So don't beat yourself up. Don't beat yourself up. When you start, you want to start that new business, when you want to engage with that new project, you're going to find out that there are so many limitations you have. There are so many things you need an upgrade on. There are so many things you need to. There are things you need to learn. There are things you need to get better at. It is not for you to beat yourself up. It is not for you to criticize yourself. It is for you to know that, yes, this is time for me to up my game. It is time for me to raise the bar. It is time for me to take my whole game to the next level. So don't beat yourself up. Mr. Detunji John and Mr. Peter Kana, thank you for coming on board. Okay, so we're talking about how you can take super control of your life and your business. The top five things you need to start doing now to save, preserve, and better position yourself and your business now and beyond this challenging time. So I've said the first thing you need to do is to take full responsibility. No blames, no excuses. Take full responsibility. Whatever you are going through now, be it in your business, be it in your financial life, be it in your relationship, I want you to see it as your fault. Yes, COVID-19 is not your fault, but there are things you don't forget about the outside things, that which is actually the second thing you have to do. Focus on things you can control. Those things that are beyond you, those things that are outside of you, that you don't have any control on, don't focus on them. Focus on what you can control. Then the third thing is to ask yourself, what can I start doing now with what I have? The skill set you have, the knowledge you have, the expertise you have, the resources you have, the contacts and connections you have, what can you start doing right now with those things? Forget about what you don't have. What can you start doing with what you have in this present moment? Then the fourth thing is for you not to beat yourself up. As like I said, the moment you start taking full charge of your life, you're going to find out that you have some weaknesses. There are things you are not so good at. There are things you still need to learn. There are things you need to get better at to take your game to the next level. So it's not time for you to go hard on yourself. It's not time for you to criticize yourself. It's not time for you to throw self-pity parties. It's not time for you to lament. Okay? It is time for you to forgive yourself. It is time for you to embrace yourself. And it is time for you to up your game. Then the fifth thing, the last but not the least, that you need to do is to be your biggest cheerleader. Be your biggest cheerleader, and that is you giving yourself the permission to rise and lead. It is human nature. We all want affirmation from people. We all want validation from people. And for most of us, when the affirmation and validation we so desire, we so need, when it doesn't, it's not forthcoming, it's more or less dampens our enthusiasm. But that is not what you want now. You have to give yourself the permission. You have to be your biggest cheerleader. You have to promote yourself. You have to talk about yourself. You have to blow your own trumpet. You have to cheer yourself on. Okay? You don't wait. Don't wait for anybody. Don't wait for your friends to believe in your dreams. Don't. Possibly you want to start a new business right now, given the situation of things. And then you want to run it by your wife. You want to run it by your husband. You want to run it by your mother. You want to run it by your father. You want to run it by your friend. You want them to tell you that it is the right thing to do. You want their approval. It is not what you want. It is not what you want. As a matter of fact, when it comes to your dream, when it comes to your unique situation, There are things you see others may not be able to see. When it comes to your vision, there are things you see others may not be able to see. There are cravings you have deep within you that others don't feel. So the moment you go looking for their approval, looking for their validation, because they don't understand you, because they don't see what you see, because they are not in your unique situation, that approval might not come. They might want to talk you out of it. Recently, I had one of my subscribers asked for my phone number. I sent him my contact. Then he called me on phone. He has been, for the past years, he had tried his hand in different online businesses, okay? And it's as though nothing is working out for him. But that is not even his greatest challenge. His greatest challenge is that his friends were laughing at him. Why? Because they told him to forget about all this online stuff. It doesn't work. But him, he has seen people that it works for, and he believes that eventually it will work for him. Just that currently he's not getting the level of result he would want. And because of that, his friends are making mock of him. His family members are like, we told you not to, but you are stubborn. You are just too stubborn for our liking. Now you see the result. So this young man called me and was complaining bitterly. I had to cancel him. I had to open up to him. I had to share with him my own story. That the beginning is not always the bed of roses. The beginning is not always easy. People will laugh at you. People will say things that will hurt you. People will exhibit some attitude, they will do some things to you that you might even be shocked. You might be shocked that this is coming from your mother. You might be shocked that this is coming from your father. You might be shocked that this is coming from your best friend. You might be shocked that this is coming from that person you've always looked up to. Yes, that's life. That's life. Does that mean you have to abandon your dreams? Does that mean you have to abandon your vision? No. It shouldn't be. You have to be your biggest cheerleader. I'm telling you, if you don't, as a matter of fact, I want you to go full in with the mindset of the world will come against me. My loved ones, my friends will turn their backs on me. I think if you start out from that position, from that mental position, it will help you go further on your dreams. It will help you go further on your vision. I do it. I don't talk what I don't do. When I embark on a new project, when I embark on a new vision, I put myself in that place where, I think a couple of months back, I made a post on that, where I asked myself, Obinna, what's the worst that could happen? What is the worst that could happen? What's the worst situation you could find yourself in going after your dream, after your vision? Who is that person you look up to most? Who is that person that you love most? Who is that person that you trust most? What if this person turns his or her back on you? Will you be able to stand it? And once you ask yourself this question, once you put yourself in that mental position, it helps you to forge ahead with your vision, no matter what. So you have to be your biggest cheerleader. You have to give yourself the permission to execute on your dreams, to start out on that new project, whatever that project is. And now you have all the time in the world to do that. Stop seeking validation of others. Stop seeking approval of others. You might keep waiting for that influencer, for that big celebrity to come and announce you to the world. But sorry to disappoint, that might never come. Does that mean you have to put away your dream? Does that mean you have to put away the project you want to start? Does that mean you have to put away that idea you should be running away with? No. So you must learn how to be your biggest cheerleader. You must learn how to be your biggest cheerleader. You must learn how to pat yourself on the back when the going is tough, when it's as though everybody has turned their back on you. Okay? So verse that these are the five things you have to do to take super control of your life. Take full responsibility. Take full responsibility. Focus on what you can control. Ask yourself, what do I have now that I can start with? Don't beat yourself up, because you're going to, once you start going after your dream, that idea, that project, that new business, you're going to find out that there are things you need to improve on. But don't beat yourself up. You might find out that there are things you've neglected all this while, but don't beat yourself up. Forge ahead. And the last but not the least, be your greatest cheerleader. Give yourself the permission to go all in on your project, on your goal, on your ambition, on your dreams, on your idea, on your vision. When things are not going out, turning out so well, pat yourself on the back, but keep going. So that's that for today's episode of the Rise and Lead Show. And as I would always challenge you, now is the time for you to rise and lead. Now is the time for you to rise and lead in your personal life and in your business life, because there is so much, there are so many people that are counting on you. So many people are counting on you, and you cannot afford to fail them. You cannot afford to fail yourself. Now is the time for you to rise and lead. So thank you so much for joining on today's episode, Mr. Ugo Umeboro. Thank you so much for coming on board. And if you find value in this show, if you think that so many, there are people that need to get to listen to this, to watch this and get value from it, please don't hesitate to share this on your timeline. I would appreciate your reaction to it, your comments, and you sharing it. This is time for us to share the light. This is time for us to share hope. This is time for us to spread positivity. The world needs it now. So feel free to share, feel free to tag your friends, and feel free to join us tomorrow on the next episode of the Rise and Lead Show. Bye, and keep being great.